Good morning. We have already derived the equations for the moment of inertia or rotational inertia of a uniform thin hoop and a uniform thin rod. Today we are deriving the moment of inertia of a uniform solid cylinder about its cylindrical axis. Bobby, what is the equation for the rotational inertia of a rigid body?
Flipping physics.
The rotational inertia of a rigid body equals the integral with respect to mass of the square of r, the distance from the axis of rotation to each infinitesimally small piece of the rigid body, dm.
Nice!
Thanks.
Bo, please read and translate the question.
Determine the rotational inertia of a uniform solid cylinder about its cylindrical axis in terms of mass m, length L, and radius R. Okay, so our knowns are capital M, capital L, and capital R, and we are solving for moment of inertia, so capital I equals question mark.
All right, let's make sure we understand some things before we begin solving this problem. First, understand that capital M is the total mass of the solid cylinder. Capital L is the length of the solid cylinder, and capital R is the radius of the solid cylinder. These may seem obvious right now, however, there are going to be more similar variables soon. Also, we need to review what the term uniform means. Billy, what does the word uniform mean in uniform solid cylinder?
The word uniform in uniform solid cylinder means the cylinder is of uniform volumetric mass density, rho.
Exactly. Now we identify the infinitesimally small pieces, dm, of our uniform solid cylinder. They are in the shape of a thin hollow cylinder. In other words, each dm is in the shape of a hollow cardboard cylinder, which holds toilet paper like this one, only the thickness of the cardboard is infinitesimally thin. Please notice the difference between the shapes of the two objects. The uniform solid cylinder and infinitesimally small pieces of the uniform solid cylinder, dm. Again, these two shapes are not the same.
Hold up, Mr. P. Why do the uniform solid cylinder and dm not have the same shape?
Yeah, why did we choose dm to be a thin hollow cylinder and not a solid cylinder?
Sure, that is a fair question. The reason dm is in the shape of a thin hollow cylinder is so that every part of dm is the same linear distance r from the axis of rotation.
That makes sense. I can see how every location on dm is located the same distance lowercase r from the axis of rotation.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. P.
You are welcome. The length of dm is capital L. The radius of dm is lowercase r, which varies from 0 to capital R. And the thickness of dm is an infinitesimally small thickness dr. Recall that because the thickness of dm is infinitesimally small, the radius r of dm goes to both the inner and outer edges of dm. Also, the mass of dm is dm. And remember the difference between lowercase and uppercase variables. In other words, the lowercase variable r refers to the variable radius of dm, whereas the uppercase letter r refers to the constant radius of the uniform cylinder.
Mr. P?
Yes, Billy?
What does about its cylindrical axis mean?
Oh, right. Let's clarify that. We are determining the rotational inertia of a uniform solid cylinder about its cylindrical axis. That means we are determining the rotational inertia or resistance of the cylinder to angular acceleration if we rotate it like this about the axis, which is the axis of the cylinder. I have labeled that cylindrical axis as the z-axis in the diagram and added a subscript of z to our rotational inertia equation to indicate we are determining the rotational inertia about the z-axis.
Got it. Thanks, Mr. P.
You are welcome. Okay, let's get back to the moment of inertia equation. Notice we, again, have this issue where we are trying to take the integral of a linear variable, lowercase r, with respect to mass. What we need to do is get dm in terms of dr, so we can take this integral with respect to r instead of m. We have done integrals like this before. Does anyone have any ideas where we should start?
Density. We use the equation for density.
Oh, right. Because the uniform solid cylinder and dm both have the same volumetric mass density, we start with volumetric mass density equals mass over volume.
And Bobby, what is the volumetric mass density of dm equal to?
The volumetric mass density of dm equals, well, the mass of dm is dm, and the volume of dm is, can we define that as dv?
Very nice, Bobby. Let's do that. And we can solve for mass dm. It equals volumetric mass density times volume dv. Now, we need to determine the volume of dv. Billy, what is the volume of dv equal to?
The volume of dv. Well, dv is a cylinder, so the area of the base times the height, or the area of a circle times height, or pi times lowercase r squared times capital L.
Actually, Billy, that is not correct.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. The shape of dm is not a solid cylinder. The shape of dm is a thin hollow cylinder or a thin toilet paper holder. So the volume of a thin hollow cylinder is...
the circumference of the circle times the height?
Yeah. 2 pi times lowercase r times capital L.
All right, we are getting closer. What you have given me there, 2 pi times lowercase r times capital L, is not a volume, it is an area. It is length times width. In order to understand how to get the volume of dv, or of a thin hollow cylinder, let's cut dv, the thin hollow cylinder, lengthwise and flatten it out. So again, we've cut it lengthwise, and we are flattening it out. Hopefully you can see that the area of dv is 2 pi times lowercase r, the circumference of the circle, or the width of one side of the rectangle, times capital L, the length of the other side of the rectangle. But what is the volume of dv?
We need to multiply that by the thickness of dv.
And what is the thickness of dv?
Dr.
Exactly. So the volume of dv equals 2 pi times lowercase r times capital L times dr. It is the volume of a rectangular box with sides 2 pi lowercase r, capital L, and dr. The reason dm is infinitesimally small is because its thickness, dr, is infinitesimally small. Okay, now we can substitute that equation for dv into our equation for dm. And we can substitute our equation for dm into our equation for moment of inertia. Now, Bo, please identify which of these are constant with respect to r, the distance from the axis of rotation to dm, so we can take them out from under the integral to simplify the integral.
Which of these do not vary with respect to radius? Well, clearly, r does change with respect to radius, so that has to stay under the integral. However, we have r squared times r, which equals r cubed. Volumetric mass density is constant. Clearly, 2 and pi, which are just numbers, are also constant. And capital L, the length of the cylinder, does not change depending on the radius, so capital L is also constant.
Thank you, Bo. Bobby, what are the limits for this integral, or the limits for the variable lowercase r? In other words, what are the possible values for the radius of dm?
The radius of dm varies from lowercase r to uppercase r.
Not quite, Bobby. What is the smallest value the radius of dm could possibly have?
Oh, right. The smallest possible radius for dm is 0, so lowercase r varies from 0 to capital R.
And those are the limits of our integral. Billy, please evaluate this integral.
Absolutely. The integral of lowercase r cubed with respect to lowercase r is lowercase r to the fourth power over 4, and we need to keep the limits of 0 and uppercase R. Now we can substitute in our limits of capital R and 0. 0 to the 4th power over 4 equals 0, and 2 over 4 equals 1/2. So the rotational inertia of a uniform solid cylinder about its cylindrical axis equals pi over 2 times volumetric mass density times the length of the cylinder times the radius of the cylinder to the 4th power. What is Mr. P waiting for?
Volumetric mass density is not one of our known variables.
Oh.
Right.
Right. Our answer needs to not have rho, the density, in it.
So, we need to substitute something in for volumetric mass density.
We know the whole uniform solid cylinder has the same volumetric mass density as dm, right?
Right. So, the volumetric mass density of the uniform solid cylinder equals total mass over total volume. The total mass of the cylinder equals capital M. What is the total volume of the cylinder?
Oh, the volume of the uniform solid cylinder equals the area of a circle times height. It equals pi times capital R squared times capital L.
And we can substitute that equation for density into the equation for rotational inertia. Pi cancels out, capital L cancels out, and capital R squared cancels out as well.
And we are left with, for the moment of inertia of a uniform solid cylinder about its cylindrical axis, 1/2 the mass of the cylinder times the radius of the cylinder squared.
So it does not depend on density or the length of the cylinder?
Nope. I guess not.
Very nice, y'all. And you are correct. The rotational inertia of a uniform solid cylinder about its cylindrical axis only depends on the mass and radius of the cylinder. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.